Hi, welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel. My name is Mark, and I think with bikes, and occasionally get to ride them too. It's been a while, hasn't it? But hey. Today, I have this early 90s Trek 7000 in the stand. Originally built and produced in 1991, this bike was a fairly well-specced rigid aluminium mountain bike. Originally, it would have come with a rigid fork and a mix of Shimano Dior LX and DX components, but over the years, it's been treated to some upgrades. And that's what caught my eye. Despite being completely collapsed, I spied a Pace RC35 fork, an early model too. Unfortunately, after the brakes were upgraded to V's, the original cantilever pivot bolt went missing, but this tired old fork was worth the asking price for the bike alone. That's exactly why I jumped at the chance to buy this bike. Often finding a complete bike with the parts you want is cheaper than buying those parts individually. But to sweeten the deal even more, this bike came with the original fork. Of course, once I got the bike home, I noticed a couple of other rarities. An anodized purple X-Lite handlebar, some Royce crank bolts, which turned out to be the steel version, and the lovely Selitalia saddle. The crank bolts are especially rare, but all these bits are going in my parts bin for an awesome brick build, while the rest of the bike gets stripped, cleaned, and rebuilt ready for the next owner. Now you might have already noticed, from a distance, this bike doesn't look too bad, but up close, it needs a lot of cleaning. I'm in for some surprises on this one, but we do end up with a lovely, clean, healthy bike. So stick around and enjoy the build.
That's seized in there. That's tight. Oh, that seems tight. No, it's mainly the wedge. The stem's free. It's tight as well. I'm getting both at once, that's why. Sorry. Okay, much better. Tube's so greasy. Can that work? I feel like this is a 26mm. I know, it's alright. Two seventy. I was 1mm off. be.
That is tight. I'm just gonna have to take it down for a sec.
Thank you.
Not like that middle chambering that I put on. I'll have to take that off for now. Oh wait, what? Also, it doesn't like the shift. So, original chamber back on. That I did kind of want to keep real racing. What the hell is that? What is that? Oh. The cage. And there we go. That's it. One clean and tidy Trek 7000, ready to be passed on to someone new. I've got a few nice bits from it, and the next person has a lovely clean base to work from. Admittedly, it wasn't quite the part switcheroo I'd intended though. It wasn't shown in the video, but the headset was switched from a Dior to a new Stronglite because of excessive wear and a cracked race. But also, the free hub disintegrated when the lockring was loosened. Luckily, I had both bits in the parts bin, so they were easy to replace, along with the usual bits like tyres, pads, chain and cassette. What I also didn't expect from this bike was a 1-inch steerer, so once I get that Pace RC35 running, I might have to switch out the steerer to go on the bike I had planned. But it's still a nice find. Anyway, that's the end of the video. Hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you want to see more, and I'll catch you in the next one.